Welcome back, guys.
Today we give an update about the Pizza Reflow oven project.
One of the news is the new oven.
The oven we used in the previous video had just 300 watts of power, and we needed something more to reach and maintain adequate temperatures.
We found the second-hand oven that we paid about $25, and it has 800 watts.
Due to this power increase, we had to change the triac of the power board with one that could stand greater currents.
And we added a small fan to cool down the triac actively.
The last very important news is that we have our control logic board, made and assembled by PCBWay, our sponsor that is helping us a lot.
Let's talk about it.
The main goal of the logic control board is to control the oven temperature, so that it follows some well-established profiles. As inputs, the board has a signal coming from the temperature sensor, and we chose a thermistor that is commonly used in the hot tents of 3D printers. As outputs, besides controlling the heating elements through the power board of Pizza Reflow, we also added a PWM channel to control a fan. Our idea is to use this fan to inject room temperature air in the oven, allowing to cool it down in a controlled way. The beating heart of the controller is an STM32, where we loaded MicroPython, and then we developed a control application. The user interface is obtained through a small OLED screen, an encoder, and a couple of buttons. We started developing the control application on this mess of wires and breadboard, and we tried to accelerate the production of the board using the assembly service of PCBWay. To use the assembly service, you need some additional information respect to the order of the PCB, like the number of unique parts, the total number of through-hole and SMD parts. Moreover, you should also provide the bill of materials, aka BOM, and the Cedroid file used by the pick and place, and it's a good practice to specify on the silk screen the orientation of the components that need it. After a fast review of your order, PCBWay will send a quotation file for your components with prices and retrieval times. If you are okay with direct quotations and if you use commonly available components, the assembly times are quite good. Finally, our board arrived and we were free from the inextricable mass of wires. As you may observe, the quality of production and assembly is pretty good. Let's see the working operations of the control application. There are two operation modes. The first one is the normal oven with timer that could be used for many different things. No, we will not use this oven for the pizza or other food, but something like PLA annealing to try to increase its stiffness and strength. The second operation mode is the reflow mode. The user can choose a temperature profile, load it and start the reflow. In our menu, you will find some tasty temperature profiles, like the margherita, the pepperoni, the Hawaiian and the ham and cheese. As Italians, we should never select the Hawaiian, but we will. Adding a new profile is quite easy. Connect the board to your PC, open the virtual drive and edit the pizza.profiles file. The profiles are a list of time-temperature value pairs. As an example, if you want to set a new profile, you can add it writing the profile name with the at tag before the name. For every following line, you should add a pair of values. The first value represents the absolute time in seconds and should increase, and the second value is the target temperature in Celsius degrees. To avoid undesired effects, the first row should be 0,27. Up to now, we tested just the margherita profile on our oven, and we optimized it for our use. Here is a graphical representation of this profile, to better visualize each reflow phase. At the moment, the oven is capable of a ramp up of maximum 1 Celsius degree per second, so the profile is a trade-off between the oven capability and the optimum profile. As you may notice, we wanted to be sure of reaching the 230 Celsius degrees, so we extended the peak duration to 20 seconds. In this way, we are able to get the full melting of the solder paste. Our hope is that getting a better insulation, the oven will be able to have a faster ramp up and a more uniform temperature in the chamber. In our firmware, we also added some settings. The most important ones are the PID control settings to change the proportional, integrative and derivative coefficients. These shall be useful during the preliminary tuning phase of the system.
Let's take a moment to talk about what went wrong.
For example, this is the first time that we sent a board to production without adequate testing.
And we had so many design bugs that we will be forced to make a second revision.
To tell the whole story, we had milled board, but we didn't have the time to solder and test it.
This costed us a lot of time and reinforced the idea of how important is a good prototyping phase.
Anyway, we are quite happy about the evolution of this project since we started to see some results.
In order to complete it, we need to add the cooling fan and improve a bit the thermal insulation.
And then we'll have fun soldering and testing various profiles.
Various pizzas. We hope you enjoyed this video. Stay safe, eat pizza and subscribe. Ciao!
Ciao.
We did a reflow test with a cheap board that is useful to do SMD soldering practice. We deposited the soldering paste manually, doing a bit of a mess, and we placed the SMD components. Then we inserted the board in the oven and used the margherita profile to solder it.